Okay, as you can see, there's still a lot going on in the back behind me. Everything is more or less over. I just want to make it clear that today really wasn't about, it wasn't about politics. It wasn't a protest. It wasn't even really a rally. I would say it was a celebration by the Thai people here. People came out in numbers as big or bigger than any of the anti-government mobs. And they came out to celebrate their institution. And their institution, yes, it's a, superficially it's a monarchy, but it's not fair to compare it to Western monarchies. And it's not fair to compare it to monarchies in the Middle East, because this was not an institution that was put into power by colonialism. This is an institution that for 700 years protected Thailand from colonization. Thailand is the only country in Southeast Asia that was never colonized by the West. And people should keep that in mind. And when Thai people come out and they celebrate like this, when they come out to see their king, they're not just celebrating one person. They're celebrating an entire institution, their history, their culture, and the institution is basically the living embodiment of their history and their culture and this unity that they've had for centuries. And I think that's something very important for people to understand about politics inside Thailand and why outsiders feel like it's so important to attack monarchy. They attack it because it is a source of strength for the Thai people. And when you're attacking your enemy, you want to wear down what's strong. You don't care about what's weak. You attack what is strong. So this is why Thai people have come out. They've come out kind of also to kind of show the world and to show other people in Thailand that there's a lot of people out here who still believe in Thailand. The Thailand that has been around for centuries. And not the Thailand that certain people are trying to transform it into.